There's a part two coming out for Drink Champs of Kanye West's interview, and they put out the trailer for it. And it looks like Kanye West going to be talking a little more of that spicy shit like he was on the first Drink Champs, right? So then we also seen he's been hanging out with Jay Prince. Jay Prince also Houston known legend, you know. Don't fuck with, you know. Hey, it's a lot of shit to go on with that name that, you know, people don't want to really say it, like the boogeyman or something. But anyways, what was I saying? So he was with Kanye, and they made a video, and this is what they had to say.
This is Ye and Jay Prince. I'm making this video to address the ongoing back and forth between myself and Drake. Both me and Drake have taken shots at each other, and it's time to put it to rest. I'm asking Drake on December 7th to join me on stage as a special guest to share the two biggest albums of the year, live in Los Angeles, with the ultimate purpose being to free Larry Hoover. I believe this event will not only bring awareness to our cause, but prove to people everywhere how much more we can accomplish when we lay our pride to the side and come together.
So, obviously, people was making jokes. They was memeing it. It looked like a goddamn hostage situation. If you know, like, now, I want to say, because I don't want to say this is accurate history. I don't want to paint a picture of what Jay Prince is, some scary villain, whatever. But just the allure that surrounds him. People are saying this looks like a hostage video for Kanye. Now, I believe myself, Kanye and Drake should piece it up. A lot of the shit, even as Kanye described it, is just like professional rap. Petty banter shit, a lot of jealousy that goes on between the two. Maybe Drake is jealous of Kanye's ability to create these like beautiful sounding, well produced albums, and Kanye's obviously a little bit jealous of Drake's continuous, long running, reigning success in the music industry. So they got like a little petty beef shit going on, and they're both trying to come together to actively free Larry Hoover, who's currently, and I learned this because I did research about this, this Supermax prison that's in America. He is in ADX Florence, which is where pretty much we put the worst of the worst people in ADX Florence, right? We put terrorists from 9/11 there, terrorists from other situations, bombers, even like domestic bombers that have bombed shit in America. We got it. There's literally in this prison, I've read this shit so many times, there's literally a CIA agent who was selling information to Russia that ended up getting multiple agents killed, serving like a 90-year, like 99 multiple life sentences in this place. Like this place, gang leaders, you look at cartel leaders, El Chapo's there, the guy that blew up the Boston Marathon, he's there waiting his death penalty trial. Like when you, this place is like, if we was in a cartoon, anime, DC comic, this is where the Joker, like this is where these people are locked up at, right? And this is where they currently have Larry Hoover locked up, who is the founder of like the GDs, right? That's what he is most widely known for. They're trying to get a freeze, been locked up for a while on a slew of charges, as you would think that come with that type of title. So I don't actually know. Like, I don't know the movement. I don't know the reasoning. I don't know what they think they can leverage to get him out, especially with the things that he was charged with. But hey, if Kanye and Drake can do that, you know, good on them. Kanye's album obviously had Larry Hoover Jr., which is obviously Larry Hoover's son on there, saying that he hasn't been able to see his dad in over like 20 something years. His grandkids, like, I think it's high time he's gonna get out. We can guarantee at this time jail is supposed to be about rehabilitation, and if he comes home, he will not be in command of the GDs, right? He won't be in command of them. He won't be ordering people to do things. At this point, he's an old man. He wants to come home and be with his family and live out the rest of his days as a free man. So I don't know if that's going to happen. You know, maybe Joe Biden trying to get the black vote. He may look at that as a good play. Maybe he goes out and does that. But that's really the only way Larry Hoover can be pardoned, is if a president puts his neck out on the line and provides that presidential pardon for somebody like Larry Hoover. So, I don't know. We'll see. But Drake and Kanye getting back together, being friends again, I think that's a good look. As I said when the whole Donda and CLB thing was going on, I think it would be great to have an album like Kanye's production on Drake rapping, singing, just Drake's whole sound. I feel like that would come out, be a masterpiece, and be like the perfect album if we're just talking about this strictly from a musical standpoint. All that behind the scenes, rich guy playing around, shit, I don't know nothing about that. But when I'm talking about the music, I think that's a win for everybody in hip-hop if Kanye and Drake can come together and create something great, especially if it's like this. This is like my dream, right? Rick Ross is dropping his album December 10th. If it wasn't for Drake, Rick Ross would be my favorite rapper, but, you know, shit played out the way it played out. But if we could get just a short 9-song, maybe even 8-song, Drake Ross collab mixtape with Kanye West producing it, praise to the heavens. I think that might be the greatest shit that ever gets released. I'm not even going to lie to you. But anyways, before I wrap the show up, because like I said, majority of the shit was about the Astro, which I had to show some clips, show some things that were going on. I want to talk about the very illustrious, the very legendary, who's turned into, in my opinion, to the old man sitting on the porch yelling at all the unvaccinated, is Howard Stern. So I made a video about Howard Stern shitting on Joe Rogan. Howard Stern was also shitting on, he shit on somebody else I made a video, I don't remember. But Kyrie, he shit on Kyrie. Now, obviously, Howard Stern has to come out, and he is now shitting on, Obama didn't free Hoover, not even a real president who was for black people, Trump did. It's over, my guy. I mean, to be honest, like, let me see something, Rick. Let me look at something. We're going to get into the Howard Stern thing in a minute. My bad. We're going to get to that in a minute. Like, let's be honest here. Like, let's be completely honest. So, if it'll pull up. You know, maybe I have to look it up on my phone. So, okay. So, Larry Hoover is currently, right? And he's an old guy now. He's an old man now. He's 70 years old. Like, we could maybe do a compassion release. Like I said, prison's supposed to be about rehabilitation. And, you know. So, Hoover is serving six, and let me show this on screen. Larry Hoover is an American gang leader, co-founder of the Chicago Street Gang Gangs Disciples. Hoover is serving 6 life sentences at the ADX Florence Prison in Florence, Colorado. He was sentenced to 150 to 200 years for a 1973 murder in 1997 after a 17-year investigation of conspiracy, extortion, money laundering, and running a continuing criminal enterprise. For leading the gang from state prison, he received a life sentence. So, with all these factors, you know, tied in, right? Like I said, if you say the idea of jail is supposed to be about rehabilitation, should there be life sentences for certain, you know, crimes, right? Murder, he murdered somebody. That's obviously a crime you should be in jail for a very long time for. But my point being is if we are allowing other people to get out in 25 years of life, this and that, you know, let them out. But there's a lot more tied in with Larry Hoover because he is the leader of a very well-renowned gang, which people in the FBI and the federal bureaus will label to plethora of other crimes. It's like, if you're the leader of this and we could tie your gang to all these things, even if you didn't directly direct them, I can see how it'd be hard for a president to come to terms with releasing somebody like this. Not because they don't want to. Like, I mean, if Obama wanted to, he could have just done it. But he's thinking about the repercussions that'll be the blowback on him. Because if we release Larry Hoover, this would be the argument on people. If we release Larry Hoover, then shit, we could release any other person that has been locked up to this magnitude. Like I said, though, he's 70. He's been in prison for a very long time. And I would assume that if he got out, he would not continue any gang-related things. So that's where the question of compassionate release or like whatever type of release comes into play. But like I did want to show you this, right? If you're still watching, these are the people that are like, because I was describing it before, but now I really want to just show you the people that we're dealing with in this prison with Larry Hoover. So let me read this comment quick. So because of Hoover, Chicago has the two biggest black gangs that will make him the villain. Shame him really did try to change things. I mean, like you hear those stories when people create gangs back in the day, especially back in the early days. They weren't created really for the crime aspect of it. They were created for protection and community and things like that. But then it just eventually turns into something like that. So, like I said, there are obviously FBI people like that are going to try to make an example. So, anyways, like I said, look at this guy. Serving 6 life sentences, French citizen and Al-Qaeda operative pled guilty to terrorism conspiracy charge 2005 for playing a key role in the September 11th attack. So, they have him in the same prison that people who committed 9/11 attacks, right? Look at this guy, serving life plus 24. These are obviously all, what does it say? These are foreign terrorists that are all in ADX 4, serving four life sentences, serving a 37-year sentence scheduled to be released. So what did he do? He's about to get released. Algerian national convicted of a 2001 conspiracy, terrorism conspiracy for planning bomb Los Angeles International Airport. 1999, it was known that he was part of the 2000 Millennium Attack plot. So he was just a part of plots, right? He didn't actually do anything. We tried to do something. So, like I said, this guy right here, the Sugar Tsama, is the Boston bomber. If you don't remember, the Boston Marathon was going on, and he was a part of the crew that bombed, and I think the other person killed themselves or was killed. We have the Unabomber, who was there as well. There's a bunch of people, not the greatest people, are in this prison. This is the espionage center. This is people who have committed espionage, which are obviously like spies who give out information, serving life sentence. Here's a guy, my bad, Robert Hassan, 15 consecutive life sentences. And then we have the organized crime figures, right? I want to read this because I think this is very interesting. James Marcello, he's serving a life sentence. Front boss of the Chicago Outfit, convicted of racketeering conspiracy and participating in 18 murders. Luis Felipe, serving life plus 45, leader of the New York chapter of the Latin Kings. Tyler Bingham, he is Aryan Brotherhood, which is obviously like the white, you know, the Nazi, pretty much the Nazi gang that is made in prison, was transferred to ADH 2006 after being connected to violent gang activities in prison. And then here's Larry Hoover, which we just read about. Jeff Fort, he is a founder of the Black Peastones gang in Chicago, convicted of drug trafficking in 1983, convicted of terrorism conspiracy in 1987, for plotting to commit acts inside the U.S. in exchange for weapons and $2.5 million for Libya. So this is, that's kind of wild. That's like that's some movie shit. Like an outside foreign leadership comes to you and your unit to commit acts of terror inside the U.S. in exchange for weapons. But he's getting out of prison. He only got 68 years for that. So, you know, it's a lot of things. Philadelphia drug pin, obviously. El Chapo's in there. One-time Brooklyn rapper Ronald Haran, a.k.a. Rod Diggs, was tried and convicted in 2014 for 21 counts, including three murders, racketeering, and drug trafficking. He has 12 life sentences. So, like I said, this is like the super jail that you would see in a DC Comics where they got Joker, the Penguin. Like, this is where they hold people that they don't want to see the light of day. They are locked down in individual cells 23 hours a day. They only get out 1 hour out of the day, which is not even outside. It's still like an insulated thing that just has like a sunroof on top. And they never, from what I read, unless you're in the minimum security or lower security part of this, if you're in the high security, this is what goes to you. You never see anybody but the people that are moving you around. Like, Larry Hoover's most likely never seen El Chapo, right? Like, Larry Hoover's never seen the guy, Robert Hassan, who was the espionage guy. Like, they don't see each other according to reports. Nobody ever sees each other. But could you imagine if all these guys who run these things came together and they got, like, their units to come and break them out? How crazy that would be? It'd just be a crazy fucking spectacle. So this is, like, shit like this is interesting to me. I always go on Wikipedia randomly and I, like, go to federal prisons and you put, like, notable current inmates, and you just read the shit that people have done. It's very wild, the shit that you read and the things that you see. So anyways, let me read some of the comments, then we'll get to the last thing. So while he was in jail, Hoover tried to change Gangster Disciples into growth and development and be for the betterment of the community. Like, that's a good, like I said, he's probably rehabilitated by now. So you think the purpose of prison is to be rehabilitated? And if I'm showing that I'm rehabilitated, at what point am I allowed to get some sort of compassion release or pardon? And not even a pardon, just whatever it's called. Like, you can still have all this shit on my jacket, right? You can still have all these felonies on me, but commuting my sentence. That's what it's called, commuting my sentence. They got all these gang leaders. This the League of Villains for real. Yo, Hoover and Fort in the same jail. Crazy. LOL. I think they said, though, that Fort got moved out of the maximum security portion of the prison. Like, he's not a part of the lockdown 24 hours. Like, there's two different, you know, camps within this one prison. And I don't think he's a part of that camp anymore. So there, he's a part of something else. From what I read. Hope you guys enjoyed that clip of the podcast, man. Make sure you subscribe on SoundCloud, Spotify, iTunes, and subscribe to this channel here, because you have clips, you have full video podcast, you have everything you want here on this channel. So select one of these videos on the side to continue your journey on the channel. Hope you guys enjoy. See you next time. Peace.